Hello, and welcome to a special pre-recorded story time. I'm Miss Beth, a librarian here at Tap Library. You never know who you might meet at our story times. So are you all ready to get started? Take it away, Miss Dreama.
Good morning, everyone. I'm missing all of you so much. I'm so happy to see you. Let's start with our good morning song. Good morning to you. Good morning to you. Good morning, all you children. Good morning to you. I'm waving to you. I'm waving to you. I'm waving to you, children. I'm waving to you. Let's clap. I'm clapping with you. I'm clapping with you. I'm clapping with you, children. I'm clapping with you. Now we're gonna hide. I'm hiding from you. Boo! I'm hiding from you. Boo! I'm hiding from you, children. I'm hiding from you. Boo! I found all of you. We're gonna start with a rhyme. We're gonna reach way up high in the big oak tree. I see something. What could it be? I climbed right up, and what did I see? A friendly owl saying hoo to me. A friendly owl? Here is that friendly owl who wants to practice his hoo with us. Can you make that sound? Okay, we're gonna sing it. It's got a nice beat. Are you ready? Owl in the tree says, hoo, hoo, hoo. Owl in the tree says, hoo, hoo, hoo. Owl in the tree says, hoo, hoo, hoo. Owl in the tree says, hoo. Did you like that song? A really good beat? Let's do it one more time. Owl in the tree says, hoo, hoo, hoo. Owl in the tree says, hoo, hoo, hoo. Owl in the tree says, hoo, hoo, hoo. Owl in the tree says, hoo, hoo. Yay, very good. I love owls. They're my favorite bird. I wanted to share a few facts that I learned about owls with you. Did you know there are over 200 different kinds of owls in the world? That's a lot of different kinds of owls. Owls come in different sizes. Some are big, some are small, some are kind of medium-sized, like this owl that I have here. Owls have very soft feathers, and those special soft feathers help them fly so quietly. You can't even hear them. They're so quiet. Owls make their homes in nests or sometimes in holes in trees. And most owls are nocturnal. Do you know that word? Nocturnal. Can you say it with me? Nocturnal. That means that they sleep during the day and they like to be active at night. Just the opposite from us, because we're usually playing all day and then sleeping at night, but not owls. And we're gonna read a story about a curious little owl. This little owl wanted to see what it would be like to be awake during the daytime. And it's called Wow, Said the Owl, by Tim Hopgood, with permission from Macmillan Publishing. And it's a book about colors. You're gonna see a lot of different colors in here. What's your favorite color? Maybe you'll see it in the story. Let's read it and find out. At night, when we are feeling tired and ready for bed, owls are just waking up. This owl's got one eye open and one eye closed. Can you do that? One eye open and one eye closed. He's just waking up. Owls live in a nighttime world. They have eyes that can see in the dark. They can see in the dark? But this little owl was a curious owl. Instead of staying awake all night, as little owls are supposed to do, he took a long nap and woke up just before morning. Wow, said the owl. He couldn't believe his eyes. The sky was a warm and wonderful pink. Look at that pink sky. Do you like pink? Wow, said the owl as the yellow sun shone through the morning mist. A bright yellow sun. Wow, said the owl as white, fluffy clouds floated through the bright blue sky. You might be able to look up at the clouds outside. Wow, said the owl when he saw that the leaves on the tree were a bright green. Do you see the bright green leaves? Wow, said the owl as the pretty red butterflies flew by. Flutter, flutter, flutter go the red butterflies. He watched them land on the bright orange flowers, which opened up in the warm sunshine. So many beautiful orange flowers. Up in the sky, the clouds turned gray and it started to rain. But the yellow sun was still shining. Wow, said the owl as a rainbow of red, orange, yellow, green, blue, and indigo, and violet filled up the sky. What a gorgeous, colorful rainbow. The little owl sat happily in the tree and watched as the sun went down and the moon came up. The daytime is full of beautiful colors, he thought. But wow, said the owl, the nighttime stars are the most beautiful of all. Too excited to sleep, the little owl stayed awake all night long, just like little owls are supposed to do. Do you see all those twinkling stars and the moon? That's what the owls see all night. Did you like that story? I hope so. I think that was a great story. Did you see your favorite color? I hope you did. So, I think Owl wants to come back out and sing another song with us. Little Owl can blink his eyes. Did you know owls have big round eyes and they can blink? Can you blink? Practice your blinking. They can turn their heads. Owls can turn their heads really far around. See if you can turn your head. Really far around. Little owl can flap his wings. We don't have wings. We have arms, but we can still pretend. And we can flap our wings. And then little owls go to sleep. Okay, let's try it together. Little owl can blink his eyes. Blink his eyes. Blink his eyes. Little owl can blink his eyes all night long. Little owl can turn his head, turn his head, turn his head. Little owl can turn his head all night long. You ready to flap a little bit? Little owl can flap his wings, flap his wings, flap his wings. Little owl can flap his wings all night long. Little owl will go to sleep, go to sleep, go to sleep. Little owl will go to sleep all day long. That was great singing, everybody. Okay, little owl, how about you sit right over here, because we are going to read another story. Owls have very, very good eyes, so they can see even in the dark. And they have very good hearing, very strong hearing. You might not be able to see the owl's ears because it might be covered by feathers, but they have ears and very good hearing. So in this story, we are going to hear some sounds. So get your owl ears ready and see what we might hear. This story is called Night Owl by Tony Yuli, with permission from Macmillan Publishing. Okay, let's read. Night Owl likes to stay up late. That's what owls like to do, right? Stay up all night. He waves goodbye to the sun and he hoots, hoo, hello to the moon. Then Night Owl looks all around. Where is Mommy Owl? I don't know. Where's Mommy? He listens and he hears a tap, tap, tap sound. Tap, tap, tap. What could that be? Is that Mommy Owl? No, that sound is too short. It is woodpecker. That's woodpecker. Tap, tap, tap. Toot, toot. Is that Mommy Owl? Toot. No, that sound is too long. That is the train whistle. Chuck, 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 chuck. Toot, toot. Night Owl listens very carefully and hears a chirp, chirp, chirp. Is that Mommy? No, that sound is too high. It is a cricket. Chirp, 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 said Cricket. Night Owl listens even more carefully and hears croak, croak, croak. Is that Mommy Owl? What do you think? Croak, croak. Who could that be? No, that is definitely not Mommy Owl. That sound is too low. That is Toad. Croak,
croak.
The sky is making noises. Pitter-patter, pitter-patter. Whoosh.
Rumble, rumble, rumble.
Night owl flies quickly home.
Boom!
What kind of sound was that? Was that maybe thunder? Boom! Night owl is brave. He is safe at home. He closes his eyes and listens carefully. Ooh, ooh. Who is that? It's Mommy Owl. Ooh. And that's the nicest sound of all to Little Owl. Thank you so much for listening. I hope you liked the stories. I hope you learned some things about owls. We're gonna sing our goodbye song so we can give a hug and blow a kiss. Everybody ready? I love you, you love me. We have fun at the library with a great big hug and a kiss from me to you. Won't you come back again very soon? Join us again soon, and maybe when you go to bed tonight, listen carefully. Maybe you'll hear a whoo, and it might be a little owl outside. And now Miss Beth wants to tell everyone goodbye.
Thank you, Miss Dreama. That was awesome. I so enjoyed learning about owls, and I hope you did too. And thank you for tuning in. We hope you enjoyed this virtual story time. Be sure to like and follow us on Facebook and Instagram at York County Public Library to stay up to date during our closure. And if you know anyone who would be interested in hearing about a virtual story time, tell them about it too. Thank you and have a great day.